welcome to fDi in the Sky, except in this episode we're down in the FT's basement. We'll be discussing rising fDi into the tech sector, startups, as well as Serbian fDi. Alex, could you kick us off with the startup, the tech headline?
Sure. So greenfield foreign investment undertaken by tech startups within our definition rose 189% between 2016 and 2018. And that was to a whopping $3.68 billion within 2018. The interesting point is they're clearly expanding internationally, and the main two reasons are to find new markets and to source talent. There's a real fight for tech talent in the world. This is part of an index we did for our latest issue of fDi magazine.
Right.
And Vilnius, the capital of Lithuania, actually came up on top, attracting just over one project per 100,000 inhabitants.
Yeah. Nice. Okay, and any other one or two other cities that you thought performed well?
Sure. So, interesting enough, Nairobi was actually the only city in Africa to feature within the index. Yes. There's all the big cities you would expect: Berlin, San Francisco, Singapore, New York, London, Paris, where there already are very developed tech scenes. But the interesting point is, if you look at it from a per capita basis, there clearly is a very different story painted.
Right. It's not all about Silicon Valley, which is great to see. Last year, Serbia saw unprecedented historic amounts of greenfield fDi. That was 107 unique projects valued at $5.8 billion. So a huge amount. And this compares to an average of around 69 projects in the year before. And they're doing fairly well going into this year as well. So what's going on behind this? It's mainly manufacturing. 50% of the investment from last year into Serbia was into manufacturing. Food and tobacco, textiles, real estate, and especially automotive components. A lot of that's coming from China, and there's actually less and less, although still very significant, investment from the EU into Serbia. So why Serbia? Very briefly, it's the most populous country in the Western Balkans. It's had a huge number of legal reforms recently in the last 4 or 5 years, as well as some very attractive incentives for investment. All in all, it's looking very up for Serbia.
Yeah.
And we'll wrap this up quickly. For our wonderful viewers, thank you for watching. And if you want to read, watch, listen to more of our stuff, you can check that out at fdiintelligence.com.